Okay, so for this revolve, that's really for all of the work on43 through 47. This is just a mirror, basically. You could do it the long way, but you would just mirror, draw half of this symmetrically and mirror it. Same thing down here. It does have a section showing you this rib right here in the middle. So this is a cross section of what this looks like down here. So it's kind of looks like a T with this part sticking up in the middle. Again, you can mirror these two sides if you want. For the fillets, it's kind of at your discretion. I would use like a 16th up here in this area, and maybe an 8th back in this area, and maybe a 16th on these, but you could eyeball it. It's not going to be right or wrong. Just don't make sure they're not too big, but these are filleted and rounded off over here. This one's pretty self-explanatory. Just be sure that you understand that this 5-inch dimension right here isn't an overall. It goes from the back of the object right here, which is flat, to this edge and corner right here. But the very front of it, this face, this surface, sticks out 0.25. So overall, it's not 5 inches, it's 5 1/4. And it does those goofy fractions to save space. Instead of 3.125, they put 0.31. So I'm sorry, 0.3125. So I put a list for you down here. This is the revolve. So we haven't learned how to do this yet. So you can see this center line right here. This is a construction line. You can make those in on shape. It's one of the items up at top that I'll show you. But you basically draw one half of this profile here. So cut right down the middle here, and you draw this one half right here with all these dimensions to kind of lock them in place there. And then you'd end up with something like this. You can kind of see there's my construction line in there that I'm going to use for the revolve, but that's the center. You can use this as a datum, so you can get dimensions off of this and things like that. But I basically made this profile of it. And then once you're done with that sketch, here's revolve right here. You'll select this sketch. Oops. And my revolve access. Sorry. And then the revolve axis is going to be this center line here. And then you can see it takes it, basically extrudes it and goes around 360 degrees based on that profile. And then there's your revolve. Oops, except it looks like it took out my round that I had in there. So do a little editing here. Should automatically update. And there you go. That's all you'll need for those.